Okay. Welcome back to Nathan Plays Badly, Civilization 6. This is part 4. Currency has been boosted. Get rid of that. Thank you. Next turn.
My liege, we are beginning to attract the attention of the great people of the world. Of course, there are other leaders vying for their attention, too.
Yep, okay.
The more specialized districts we construct, the more we will draw in specialized great people to share their talents with our civilization. I advise that we continue to build these.
I'm almost to the point of turning her off, but I'm not quite sure how to do that. Bronze working. Bronze is the mirror of the form. Wine of the mind. Because she keeps talking out.
We have recently gained advanced knowledge in city planning.
And I've been told
creating districts in our cities can be much more powerful and lucrative than simple improvements like farms and mines. My liege, we have an envoy at our disposal. We can use the envoy to gain...
Thank you! Okay. I've been thinking about this. Shipbuilding. Allows to embark... Gives us the quadrilene. If I go for this for 19 turns, which isn't all that long, then I can embark, and because of Norwegian's special ability, I can enter ocean tiles once I research this. So we're going to skip ahead to this, and then we'll come back to masonry and wheel and other stuff. I'm also going to zoom in just a little bit farther. Move this ship here, and then I will be ready to move across the ocean when the time comes. She still said we had an envoy. Because I never
confirmed
the placement.
Our city-state neighbors have made a request of us. If we can impress them, I think they will reward us handsomely.
Okay, what's your request? You have met a new city-state. Construct holy site. I already have. Just completely ignore the ability to go there. Okay. Russia has founded a religion, Eastern Orthodox. Speaking of religion, there are two. My pantheon. I have a pantheon already. God of the Sea. Production of plus one production from fishing boats. So I need a great profit. I'm behind two other unmet players. Okay, so that's the guy I kept seeing in the capital. Over here, I want a builder. There's a society to emulate. Art, science, what don't you have? Well, thank you. Growing number of citizens in your land dream of having an empire. Your development of an early empire is now complete.
It was luxuries like air conditioning that brought down the Roman Empire. With air conditioning, their windows were shut. They couldn't hear the barbarians coming.
Okay, well, let's take a look at policies. New policy, reduce the cost of purchasing tile by 20%. I still want to keep faith up in... my city. However, I do want something new for... production towards settlers. I do want something new for military policy. This one. 50% production towards ancient and classical era melee and ranged units. My next thing, I guess, over here again after 5, is going to be to build 2 archers and probably another warrior. Might not have time for all that. Okay, let's need more housing. Capital city needs more housing to keep growing. This continues the difficulty gaining new citizens. 4 or 5 housing. Turns till growth, though. Okay. Well, might not be doing that immediately then. Okay, political philosophy. They seem to have gotten a handle on their barbarian problem. At least they're starting to. I'm going to move him over here. Barking from there, going this way, will be faster that way. Is there a way through here? Seems highly unlikely, but... Actually, come to think of it, for him to upgrade, for any of them to upgrade, they might actually have to be in a city radius. Come to think of it. There's not a way through there. Already got the ability to go in ocean squares? I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Okay. If I take 8 turns to build a granary, then, I'll have my housing problem fixed, or I can Archer. You know what? Let's do Archer first, then we will do Cranery. Okay. Bill Plantation. Buy something. I don't know if I could buy the granary. We'll do that and increase our. Okay, part of the long thing for growth is because we were reaching the end. Suppose there's anything else that could be bought now. About land. Land's still doable. Maybe not here. Buy land. I want to buy land over here. Okay. Explanation is they've already got what they need to transverse ocean. So, as I'm sure upgrades are going to require... being in a city radius, I should probably move my people up into that city radius. Now domesticated into pastures, it's time to learn to ride. Knowledge of horseback riding has advanced considerably. Okay, so our monument is done. That's all we can do in the city center over there. Really? Oh, our archer's done too. Build wonder here. Oracle. Well, I can build a granary, I can build a holy site, hanging gardens, another two marsh areas. Settler builder. Archer. Housing over here. Entered the classical era. The ingenuity of your great person has unlocked new scientific ideas. Your knowledge of ironworking has advanced considerably.
I cannot imagine any condition which would cause a ship to founder. Modern shipbuilding has gone beyond that.
Yeah. That was the captain of the Titanic. Who said that? Okay. So, research. Let's do the wheel. Six turns. Hasn't shown up on my map. Roads upgraded. Classical roads is unlocked. Upgrading all the roads in your territory. Plus one movement point regardless of terrain. New city state quests. So, request a trade route. And ironworking has been boosted. Oh, it's their own. What? The only change that was some culture and some money.
Under the white cliff's battlemented crown, hushed to a depth of more than Sabbath peace.
Cliffs of Dover. Oh. So I discovered a village, and I discovered a natural wonder, the Cliffs of Dover. Another village. There, that's awfully close to that barbarian camp. I don't like that at all. Otherwise, I have to come down here and land. That's all awfully close to those archers. We'll see what it looks like when I get in there, though. And yet another. Oh, down here. Village. I'm guessing these are underexplored islands because nobody has been able to get to them yet.
Don't reinvent the wheel. Just realign it.
Our friendship with Russia has expired. Your offer is kind, I accept. For the good of my people and yours. I'd say probably more for the good of your people than for mine. Actually, you got a pretty good army going on. You're getting experience points. Wazoo, because you're fighting barbarians. Okay, choose research. Well, the only thing really left is masonry and the class. classical era. I don't see myself building a quarry anytime soon, so no reason to delay that. Then I'm guessing I'm going to go for celestial navigation, because it'll give me the ability to build their armor. And traders to embark, which I need to complete Soul's new quest. Earned experience, so it can be promoted. Plus 7 combat strength versus melee and ranged units. Plus 10 combat strength when defending against ranged attacks. Seriously? Do I really want to get rid of this camp? Because this camp keeps spitting out barbarians that keep attacking Russia. This could be a good thing or a bad thing. In games past, barbarians have pose much of a problem. It can be more of a problem in this game. They'll gang up on you though. I can see this as a good thing. If you're the one who's not being ganged up on. considering they're at half strength, I'm going to say this isn't a good thing. Take the money. Get a settler in 26. Well, you know what? Builder in 14. Don't like that either. I need the two housing from the granary. I really do. Can't purchase anything yet. Okay. So much untapped potential here. I would really love to put a new city here and right over here near the Cliffs of Dover, but also the Siren. But I can also imagine that if I don't move quickly, I'm going to lose them. Somebody else is going to put a city somewhere too close to those spots, but not in those spots.
The opportunity has arrived for a change into a new and more powerful system of government. Let us strengthen our identity and enact more policies to govern our people.
Politics is the art of the possible, the attainable. The art of the next best.
Alright. Classic Republic. All cities with a district receive plus one amenity. Aristocracy. Capital receives plus one boost to all yields. Oligarchy. All land melee units gain plus four combat strength. Percent experience for combat units. Well, we're going to go for oligarchy because it's going to give us one of each. I have new diplomatic policies. Let's see here. The first envoy you send to each city state counts as two envoys. Plus two influence points per turn, earning city state envoys. And plus two great profit points. Right now. Okay, we're now ahead in the Great Prophet. I got 63 of 90. This way. Why did you? Ah! Seriously! Choose a civic. Games and Recreation is next. And then we'll start our turn next time.